everyone. In this video, I will still also solve from the AJU 2019 and still from part 2, but this is question number 2. Okay? In question number 1, they talk about factor, and for the second question or question number 2, we talk about complex number, yeah, complex number. Alpha, beta and gamma. Yeah, represent A, B and C. Okay? After look of this problem, I saw this is quite difficult with some manipulation algebraic, yeah. Okay, let's see. They given that this is the first sentence here, first sentence, and this is the second sentence given from the problem. Okay, they ask from these two information, we have to find triangle of ABC. Okay, let's do. From one, this is the clue. From this, we need to find here first. Okay, so from first sentence, gamma minus alpha square plus gamma minus alpha times beta minus alpha plus beta minus alpha square equal to zero. I will divide both sides. Divide by beta subtract by alpha squared, yeah. So the first part here become gamma minus alpha squared over beta minus alpha squared. In the middle one we will cancel one b minus alpha, so we got here and the last one become one, right? Because this is exactly the same way with this one, yeah. Okay, let's continue. I think I can simplify, become like this, gamma minus alpha over beta minus alpha squared here, and this is also gamma minus alpha over beta minus alpha plus one. This is like looks like quadratic equation, like this is p squared plus p plus one, yeah. Equal to zero, where p equal gamma minus alpha over beta minus alpha. Okay, so we have to solve this one using quadratic formula, p minus b plus minus square root of b squared minus 4ac over 2a, right? So we got here p minus 1, 1 minus 4 become this one and 2, yeah. So from here we replace p with here, so we got gamma minus alpha over beta minus alpha is minus 1. This is become e square root of 3, right, over 2. Or we can also write like in form like this. Okay, so this is gamma minus alpha over beta minus alpha here. Okay, so we can put it here into here. Okay, so here this is become 1, this is 3 and this is 2, right? Yeah, this is 1, this is 3 and this is 2. Okay, from here. Okay, continue. They also ask about the modulus of this one and the argument of this one. Okay, the modulus is the modulus of gamma minus alpha over beta minus alpha is the real part square root of real part square plus the imaginary part square. From here we have 1/4 plus 3/4, so this is become 1, square root of 1 become 1. Okay, so the value of our modulus of this complex number is 1, yeah. You just put it here, this is will be 1. Okay, and now we find the argument, yeah. The argument we got from tangent, right? Tangent of argument gamma min alpha over beta min alpha equal imaginary part, this one, over real part. Okay, so imaginary part here over the real part. So from here we got negative positive square root of 3. Okay, in the argand diagram, if you realize, yeah, the value of y is positive and negative, but the value of x is negative. So it should be, the point should be like in, should be in here and in here, here or here, because in this point the real part is negative but the imaginary part is positive, and the other hand, for the next point the real part is negative and the imaginary part is also negative. So we put it here, here it is the argument, yeah, because this is special angle for tangent. So we got this is 120, or this is negative 120, or if we convert the degree into the radian will be 2 over 3 pi or negative 2 over 3 pi. So from here we got argument gamma minus alpha will be positive negative 2 third pi, yeah. So from here we put it here 2 third, 2 and 3. Okay, yeah, let's continue. This is another manipulation algebraic, yeah. From here, from beta minus 2 alpha plus gamma, they ask, we have to change become this form. Okay, I realized that beta minus 2 alpha plus gamma, actually this is come from here plus gamma minus alpha, right? Beta here, and this is minus 2 minus alpha and minus alpha become minus 2 alpha, and this is gamma, right? Okay, okay, this is keep the same from the previous. We got here, right? We got here. Okay, okay, so I just put it like here, just cross multiplication like this, and we substitute this form into here. Okay, so we got here here, and I factorize this equation, become 1 minus half plus minus half e square root of 3. So from here I simplify, 1 minus half become half plus minus half e square root of 3. Okay, so this is answer this part. Okay, this should be half, and this is 3 half. Okay, so this is 1, this is 3, and this is 2. Okay, let's continue. From 2 here, we have here. Okay, let's check what we have in 2. 2 say is here. Okay, 2 say here. Okay, I put it here. This is what to say. This is what to say. The modulus of this one equal 3, okay? The modulus of this one equal 3. This, if we have two complex number, it will be like this. Okay? If you multiply two complex number and we find the modulus, it will be have the same exactly like you find the modulus of each complex number and you multiply it. It will be the same, yeah? So here, if I have modulus this one, it will be equal modulus of this one. And according to this properties, I can say this is can be like this. This one, right? The modulus of this one, we already find it. This is equal 1. Okay, this is equal 1. So this is equal 3 from the second here. This is 3. So we got the modulus of B minus beta minus alpha will be 3, right? From here, okay? So we got here become 3. Okay, last part. Finally, the area of triangle ABC. Okay? Look at this form, yeah? Okay. Okay. Let's check. Let's say this is, I draw arbitrary triangle. This is, I called A, this is B, and this is C. Okay? This is what we call B minus beta minus alpha, and this is what we call gamma minus alpha. Okay, so the area of ABC we can use half times the length of the modulus of the length of this one times the length of this one times the sine of this angle. Okay, the modulus of beta minus alpha, the modulus of gamma minus alpha, and times by sine theta. This is, I just write it theta. Okay, here we have from here 3, right? Okay, 3. And gamma minus alpha, I think gamma minus alpha we also find from here, right? From here, gamma minus alpha will be beta minus alpha, right? Because the modulus of here is 1. So, the modulus of gamma minus alpha will be the same with beta minus alpha. Yeah, because this is 1, okay? So, this is also 3. And we need to find this one. If we got this, the problem is solved, okay? Sin theta. Theta is between the angle beta min alpha and gamma min alpha, right? Okay. Okay, we can try to find the theta here by using this one. Okay. Remember the properties argument. If you have the argument of two complex number like this, it will be argument of z, the one complex number negative argument of the other complex number like this. We will use this property. Okay, so because you have argument of gamma minus alpha over beta minus alpha, it will be, according to the properties, it will be argument gamma minus alpha minus argument beta minus alpha, right? In this picture, argument of gamma minus alpha actually is here. If this is the x-axis, actually this angle is argument of gamma minus alpha, and the small angle here is argument of beta minus alpha. So theta itself is this one negative this one, right? You can see from this picture, this is whole and this is the other two parts, right? So we can say this is actually theta, yeah, theta. And we already have the argument of gamma minus alpha per beta minus alpha is this one, right? Positive negative 2/3 pi, yeah. So here theta will be 2 third pi or 120 degree. So just put it here, sine 120 become square root of 3 divided by 2. So this is like this, 3 times 3 is 9, so the area become 9 over 4, 2 times 2 is 4, square root of 3. So this is the final result, 9 per 4 square root of 3, and we submit to here, 9 square root of 3 over 4. Okay, thank you for watching this video. Hope this has helped you to prepare your examination. See you in my next video.